Hello, everyone. My name is Laverne Cox, and I am so excited to be with you today. I am being joined by Peppermint and Juku, and today we're going to be talking about the legacy of transgender women in drag. Peppermint, can we start with you? Because you competed, obviously, on RuPaul's Drag Race, and you're an openly trans woman. You came out on the show and stayed on the show. Can you talk a little bit about your relationship to being a woman, a trans woman, and also being a drag person?
There's often confusion around drag versus trans. Is drag an identity? Is it an expression? Is it a career? And I guess the short answer is it's all of those things. The identity of being a trans woman crosses paths with the opportunity to do drag or perform in drag, especially given that many trans people, especially historically, haven't had the opportunity to safely transition in their own spaces. Doing drag is that safe space to experiment with gender, express what you want with gender. And so it kind of becomes this, it's a safe room where everything goes. And some people leave that space just kind of with the conclusion that they're just a performer. And some people leave that space with a heightened knowledge or awareness that they are also trans. And some folks move on from leave drag, you know, kind of behind and say, that helped me. It was a stepping stone to get to where I am. And some of us continue to do drag because it earned some coin.
I started doing drag before I came into realization. If you were to look at my timeline, it's as if I was fully realized before I started doing drag, because as a child, as a teenager, I didn't know what trans was necessarily yet. This was maybe, and I know you guys are gonna kill me, but this was like maybe like 2013, 14.
Can you disclose your age, Juku?
I'm 21.
Work.
I'm like, I don't want to be that girl right now, but I'm that girl.
Own it, honey. It's all
be
good.
be that girl, because you won't be that girl forever, honey.
I know, you're right. But my freshman and sophomore year, I really started tapping into my femininity. I was, you know, like, I was that like bandy ass bitch that was just like roaming the halls with my fucking boobs, just like killing it. But I didn't know that there was an essence there, and that there was an energy in me that, you know, later in 7 years time, I would realize meant that I was a woman. I also do just want to say that I'm honored to be in the presence of both of you, because I've been freaking out all day, and I love Peppermint so much, and seeing her on TV as a trans woman a couple of years ago was just all the things that I needed. So thank you, Peppermint, and thank you, Laverne, for doing what you do and continuing to do the damn thing.
We're doing this in conjunction with the film Disclosure, the documentary that I executive produced that looks at the history of trans representation on screen. And there is a film called Queen from the late 1960s with Mother Flawless Sabrina that is a drag pageant, a female impersonation pageant, is the language they used at the time. And we know now that Crystal LaBeija, in that famous, from the famous scene at the end of the film, indeed identified as a trans woman.
She won't make money off of my name, darling. She can make it off of Harlow and all the rest of the fools that will flock to her, but not Crystal, darling.
Peppermint, what, can you talk to us a little bit about Queen, when you first saw it, what that film means to you as a trans, as a woman at the intersection of being trans and also a drag performer?
I really honestly didn't know that much about the movie Queen until I was already steeped pretty deep in the drag lifestyle. Of course, the quotes for me, the quotes preceded the film.
Which and quote did so, you hear? Which, do you remember which quote you heard?
Look at her makeup, it's terrible. You know, all of those.
She better get the hell back to Philadelphia, because she's one of the worst. And where's Miss Sabrina? Because I'll sue the bitch.
Did you sign
I will sue, no, I didn't sign any release. And if she releases any bitch on me, I will sue the fool.
So I guess that language was really already a part of sort of my vocabulary and lexicon before I even knew that I had been working with Mother Flawless Sabrina at the tunnel for years. And this is someone who I knew. I didn't even know that these were the same two people, that this person was the same person.
Miss Crystal, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the third runner-up of the 1967 Nationals.
To know that someone who became such a part of bringing Crystal LaBeija to us in the way that we're able to receive Crystal by way of this, the drag pageant or the female impersonation pageant or drag balls that they were calling them. I was really happy and pleased to see that I had a connection to the film past just kikiing about the quote.
Juku, do you know Queen? Have you seen Queen?
Yes, I've seen the Queen once. I find it quite interesting that in the movie, the men that do drag in that film are very like, oh, we are not women. Like, I don't want the surgery. I don't, but baby, we know now that that doesn't make you a woman. So it's kind of really interesting to see how far the language has come. Yeah. In being that not all women need to have the surgery to be women.
It's also interesting that just watching some of those conversations when they're in the room getting ready, that some of those conversations are the same exact conversations
right.
that we're having, either in
right.
the drag circles or the trans drag circles or the trans specific circles. Many of them are the same conversations, maybe with updated language.
What's fascinating to me is that there would even be a conversation that, like, in the late 1960s, that if you are a drag performer, that the question of the surgery will come up. And so that their focus was sort of on surgery and to surge or not to surge, if you will. And that was deeply fascinating to me. And we know now, I think Harlow, who did win the pageant, that she came out as trans just a few years mm-hmm. after the pageant, so it wasn't just Crystal. And so the intersections of so many, and just my own history of drag, it's really weird because when I worked at Lucky Chang's, I never called myself a drag queen. I called myself a trans woman working in the context of drag, because I was clear that I wasn't really doing drag. I was a performer.
Years ago, people would ask me, and I really wanted to sort of make a distinction between being a drag queen and then just working at a drag bar or being a performer. And so in that conversation, I remember trying to distinguish, I'm a performer. And even more than that, I remember it was so sort of crucial for me to establish my look as looking natural and real and passable. That was really important for me. I would have never worn like blue hair or like, you know, brightly colored makeup or anything like that. I wanted to be just as natural as possible. It was probably a little bit after Drag Race, honestly, where I was able to kind of establish myself solidly in both spaces that I suddenly was like, okay, I have to come to terms with this. I'm a woman no matter what, no matter how I look, whether people read me as a woman or not, whether I have brown natural hair or blue rainbow hair, I'm a woman, and if I'm doing drag, staying up next to a bunch of cis men who do drag, I'm still a woman. And that took a lot for me to kind of work through, mm-hmm. and I did.
I mean, this entire conversation is about trans women and the impact that they've had in the drag community. The most impactful performers that I've seen in my life, the performers that have driven me to become who I am today in terms of who I am on stage are specifically trans women. And there are so many inspiring trans women that I think people should go on YouTube and maybe check out, like Tandy Andrews, Erica Andrews, Chantel DeMarco, Dina Cass. If anyone out there is watching this, continue to support trans performers. The talent is there, we are here, and we're not going anywhere.
Thank you everyone for watching. Thank you so much, Peppermint. Thank you, Juku. This
Thank
has
you.
Been so wonderful.